Adam, Houston, Texas, we got myself and the Mobidiots. This was the very first record that we ever did.
Mm-hmm.
This is a record that sent me in search of a band, and I came up with the Moon Band, and we became Moby and the Moon Band. This was previously Moby and the Mobidiots.
Right.
A song that was ripped off by Men at Work, and they did it, and they called it Down Under, if you can believe that crap. This is Up Yonder on 97 Rock, the rock of Houston, Texas.
The parking lot of a mall, met a young man with a U-Haul. He said, I'm lost, can you direct me? I'll take a job in the land of plenty. And I said, do you come from the land up yonder? You move south and no wonder, it's a land of endless summer. Can't stay, but don't touch my sister. Having lunch with a man from New York, I taught him how to eat with a fork. He tried so very hard to thank me. I said, no, I'm sorry for you Yankees. And he said, I come from a land of yonder. He said life here is much worse. Then he smacked my face with his purse. And I said, you come from the land of yonder. You move south and no wonder. It's the land of endless summer. You can't stay, you dress like my sister.
Hi, this is Brian Adams. You're getting Mobivated on 97 Rock.
I should have seen it coming, baby.
think she needs me. Well, it must have been blind. She didn't give me a warning. She says, I shouldn't treat you wrong. When I woke up this morning, she was gone.
Take me back. Yeah. We'll say that to Ed Biles now. Is Ed Biles saying it to us? Knock, knock.
Oh, yeah.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Thank you. Ed Biles.
Ed Biles who?
See how quickly we forget.
I know. Okay. Yeah.
Right. Chuck Studley hasn't forgotten, though, has he?
No.
Just said in the paper this morning, Chuck Studley is sincerely doubting he'll have his job 3 games from now.
Think so?
Yeah. Wouldn't this be a great time for another football strike? Do you know why rodeo cowboys make such good lovers?
No.
Why they make such bad lovers? Boy, I can't do nothing right this morning.
Wait a minute.
Take two. Why do rodeo cowboys make such bad lovers?
Gee, Moby, I don't know.
Because they think 8 seconds is a good ride.
We got some people in from Los Angeles listening to us this
morning.
What's
worse than a guitar string breaking in the middle of a tune?
What is worse than a guitar string breaking in the middle of a tune?
Your organ going flat in the middle of a piece.
Hi, California.
Where are you going to rock this weekend? The answer, it's easy. The hottest rock and roll club on the north side of Houston, Goodies. Goodies, the only live rock club on FM 1960, has live music on stage tonight till 2 a.m. You said you wanted late night partying. Hey, you've got it. A mile and a half west of the North Freeway on FM 1960. You wanted a great happy hour? Well, you've got that too. Goodies 2-for-1 happy hour from 7 till 9 tonight is going to relax you after that long day and then wind you up again for a great night of partying. So be there early or be there late. Goodies has live music on stage tonight till 2 a.m. And remember, Sunday night is Goody's Wet T-Shirt Contest with a $100 cash prize, 97 minutes of 97-cent beer and bar drinks, and live rock and roll on stage. So come on out and party with me, Garth Hemp of 97 Rock, at Goody's, your rock and roll showplace. Goody's.
Well, anyhow, we are 97 Rock, KSRR Houston.
And it's been a pretty good old morning here on the rock and roll radio station. Monday we'll get things back to normal, I reckon.
I hope so.
Then we got 2 weeks from today. We leaving for London. Get down, England, Bubba.
On your 30th birthday.
On my 30th birthday, we're leaving for London. I wonder if we could, do we have to work that morning?
Of course.
Of course. I mean, it seems like a guy, how many times in your lifetime do you turn 30?
Once.
I'd like to have the day off that day.
No.
I don't want to be around.
No.
I want to be somewhere just lost in oblivion.
No.
About Wednesday of that week and just come to in London.
No.
You know, with Princess
no.
Di naked in front of me.
Oh, no.
See?
No.
So let's make another Prince Bubba.
No.
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 Oh, well. All right. Never mind. It's 10 o'clock from 97 Rock and Lauren Valley's on the radio. In just a minute, John, let's get out of here.
All righty.
It's been a good morning. Hi, it's off the Marquis de Sade State Bay Building here in lovely Medical Center area of Houston, Texas. We've enjoyed it. If you come by our building, be sure to stop in the lovely grease pit they call a restaurant on the first floor, where you can pick up a grilled cheese sandwich and Coke for $7.95. It's a special today and today only. They're closed today.
The hair in it's free.
Because illegal aliens don't work on holidays. It's Thanksgiving in Mexico. Too. Let's go.
Bye, Mr. Moby.
Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.
It's been a good time. Y'all take care. Bye-bye. Bye, John.
Bye, Moby.
I love y'all. We do love you. Take care of yourselves, and we'll see you back here Monday morning on 97 Rock.
Better to be burning for you. than from you.
Oh.
Blue Oyster Cult on 97. Right. Good morning, Houston. It is 7:31. John, you remember the gay Irishman joke we told a while ago? Did you hear about the two gay Irishmen? John Fitzgerald and Gerald Fitzjohn?
Yeah.
Which was real great. Well, this guy caught up with a related joke here.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Oh, you're talking about the two gay Irishmen?
Right,
Did you hear about the new game they're playing in Montrose?
Montrose game, what?
Swallow the leader.
Swallow the leader.
Oh,
no.
Hey, Moby, here's your buddy.
Oh, you're my buddy, man. Thanks a lot. Oh, my goodness. Can we get away with that?
I bet it.
Swallow the leader.
Stop.
Oh, I can't wait to see the voice again this week. Oh, boy, here come more letters, more letters. Write the president, okay?
Moby.
Mathews gives us information in just a second. We'll follow that with William Squire on 97 Rock.
$1,000. It's the original, and tonight, in an unprecedented entertainment move, Struts will give away $1,000 to the finest-looking woman in a bunny costume.
$1,000.
And the winner will be assured of a place in the next Struts MTV commercial.
Now that's hot.
Struts sets a new trend nearly every night. Struts with live entertainment from WW3. And, of course, the best nightly specials with dollar drinks from 8 to 10 p.m. for everybody. Join us tonight. Plus, the 97 Rock Air personalities will be in attendance to help select the best-looking bunny in costume and award her $1,000 in cash. Struts, it's easy to find. Just look for the sign in the sky at I-45 North and Aldine Road. And welcome home to the original Struts.
7:38.
My, how you ran on.
How I ran on?
Yes.
It was you that had all this news on.
You were the one on the soapbox.
Well, I deserve... Man, that kid... What's that kid's name?
Troy Erickson.
Troy Erickson. Troy, man, you stand your ground. Stand your ground. Your daddy will put you in another school until you get this stuff worked out. That's ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
It's absolutely ridiculous. Teachers and faculty and administrations of schools should educate. Period. Period. Morals are taught at home. Okay, this makes me mad. You know, it's like the kids have enough problems now without having to deal with redneck teachers. Let's all be open-minded about this stuff.
Yeah.
That's enough. You want me to hush now?
I sure wish you would.
No problem. All right, who's my buddy?
Hey, I'm your buddy, Moby.
All right, thank you. Foreigner, hot-blooded out of the Double Vision album. 97 Rock, good morning. It's 747. Get your lazy asses up and motivated. We got a cloudy-looking Wednesday midweek morning out there, 63 degrees. We might get some rain before this here day is over, dear hearts. I want you to know. Okie dokie, 97 Rock. It's 752. Need to say hello to Carol Friedman this morning. Scott Hester, hi, both y'all. Bruce Phillips is celebrating his 24th birthday today. Happy birthday, Brucey boy. And Lisa Gant is 14 years old today. So we got all that out of the way. Hello, Houston. Up and at 'em now. This is Men at Work on 97 Rock. They'll have an album coming out real soon called Cargo. This is like advanced music from that called Overkill. Men at Work on Houston's Rock of the 80s.
About the implications of diving in too deep, and possibly the complications, especially at night. I worry over situations. I know we'll be alright. Perhaps it's just an imagination. Desperation, at least there's pretty lights. Though there's little variations, it nullifies the night from overkill. Day after day, we appear. Night after night, my heartbeat shows.
Tonight's green light special is over in our Clear Lake area on NASA Road 1, right behind Jason's Restaurant in the party department. Just look for the brown saloon and great specials for the ladies,
like no cover charge, 75-cent draft beer and bar drinks, and great rock and country music to dance to. This is a limited offer. It only happens every Wednesday night at the Brown Saloon. Saloon. Your place to party every night is the best place to party on Wednesday nights. Guys, come on out and meet the ladies.
Ladies, come on out and get in on the 75-cent draft beer and bar drinks, all the great rock and country dance music, the Brown Saloon's dance floor light show, and the free cover, and of course, meet the guys.
Start your party early and get to the Brown Saloon for happy hour from 4 until 7 with 2-for-1 draft beer and bar drinks, and then stick around for
Ladies Night, tonight at the Brown Saloon, NASA Road 1, right behind Jason's Restaurant, 1/2 mile east of El Camino Real.
The chairman of the House Committee on Urban Affairs has set an April 6th deadline for a lobbyist to submit a full financial report on his efforts to keep lawmakers from legalized horse race gambling. State Representative George Pierce wants to know whether out-of-state interests are paying for the campaign by Alan Maley Jr. Now, Maley represents a group called Texans Against Gambling. And Maley says that, to his knowledge, his lobbying has not been backed by money from anybody connected to any existing racetracks. There is a suspicion among some lawmakers that owners of racetracks out of state are financing the campaign in Texas.
So they can open up racetracks in state?
No.
No?
No, the out-of-staters want to keep it horse race gambling out of Texas.
Maybe I should listen when you read these before I say anything.
Good idea. Uh-huh. It was 2 years ago that John Hinckley tried to kill President Reagan, wounding the president and three others. Now everybody has recovered, except Presidential Press Secretary James Brady, who was shot in the brain. In an interview for NBC's Today Show, Brady says he doesn't wish Hinckley any evil. He just hopes Hinckley doesn't win the Irish sweepstakes. It's Easter break.
Did Brady really say that?
Yes. He's a clever guy.
Yeah. If he had half a brain, he'd quit that job.
Stop,
you know?
That.
He must have had a hold of his head to take
stop
it to begin
it.
With.
Stop it.
Reagan's going to fire him anyhow. You know that?
No.
Everything he tells him goes in one ear and out his forehead.
Would you stop that?
I'm sorry.
He's a courageous man.
I know that.
It's Easter break at the nation's colleges, and thousands of students have invaded Florida beaches. Officials at Fort Lauderdale have attempted to break the sun, suds, and sex image of the yearly gathering by sponsoring clean fun alternatives. These include windsurfing races, tug-of-war contests, volleyball games, and free concerts. The students seem delighted, but the effort has not stemmed the flow of beer. Yeah. One said one University of Massachusetts student is great as he was crammed into a bar with hundreds of other men watching young women parade around in panties and sheer nighties.
That's disgusting.
For a wet nightgown contest.
Yes.
Other popular establishments offer wet t-shirt contest, bikini contest, and male strippers.
And then you got the calendar girl contest.
Mm-hmm. Officials estimate close to 1 million students will visit Florida's beaches during their spring reprieve from Texas.
Wonder how many they are estimating they're going to get arrested down there on Florida's beaches.
Probably several hundred, I guess. Always happens.
You know, they quit having jails over there after they get like a few hundred thousand in jail.
Mm-hmm.
They just start burying them up to their neck in the sand. Let the sand crabs do the rest.
What kind of sports story would you like to hear?
Oh, I don't know. Bowling? You have any bowling?
I got pole vaulting.
Pole vaulting. Let's do pole vaulting.
Brad Pursley of Abilene Christian University.
No, never mind. I thought this was a John Holmes story.
Well, goodness gracious.
No?
Anyway, he set a record for pole vaulting. That's really nice. He cleared 18 feet, 10 and a half inches.
Ooh,
and the Rockets
that's
lost
better than John Holmes by a mile.
Stop
man.
It.
What does he do with that thing?
Stop it.
Whoa. God. 18 feet, 10 and a half inches?
Why do I do this to
Woo.
Myself? Why
do I you do could have left the feet out and I would have still been impressed.
The Rockets lost 111-95. This time it was to the Kansas City Kings.
Let's stick to basketball,
mostly
yeah.
Cloudy. We got rain throughout the day today, getting up to about 75 right now in Houston at 63. I'm John Mathews, 97 Rock.
Boy, it's 8:07 already. John, you know that?
Vim's going to get you.
Yeah, he's going to get you. It's you that read all that. You that insist on doing that long pole vaulting story. 18 feet, 10 and a half inches. Wow, man. I bet John Holmes is glad he's in prison.
Stop
He'd
that.
He'd be ashamed.
Holmes
about
is not in prison.
Huh?
Holmes is not in
Did
prison.
Did he get out?
Yes, quite some time ago.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
They did?
He was never convicted of anything.
They didn't have room in one of them little cells
Stop
anyhow.
It. Stop
they said,
it.
Okay, Holmes, you're in the cell, but that thing goes in the broom closet.
Stop it.
Good morning. Up and out of Houston, Texas. Let's get our lazy asses up and out of that bed. Now say good morning, Moby. Say good morning, Moby.
Moby?
Yeah, say good morning. You say good morning, Moby.
Good morning, Moby.
Thank you. This is ZZ Top on 97 Rock.
Seeger.
97 Rock. Good stuff.
Come on, Bobby. Come on, May the 7th, man. That's the date we'll see that bad dude right here in Houston, Texas.
That'll be good, too.
It's 8:17. Good morning, Houston. Get your lazy asses up and out of that bed. It's 64 degrees and cloudy and yucky looking outside. And we might get some rain before this day's done, too. My good buddy and my partner, my newsman and weather person, Johnny Mathews, has promised that we might get some rain today.
Might do it.
Might do that. Oh, wait. Did you read in the paper today, John, where they had some punk Nazis? And seriously, you didn't see that?
Did you say punk Nazis?
Punk Nazis in Yugoslavia. They've locked them up, two of them, two kids for 60 days each. They were, you know, saying how great Hitler was and all that stuff. They locked them up. You can't say that over there. Here, that's the wonderful thing about America. You can say whatever you want to say.
That's right.
You know, whether you agree or disagree, doesn't ain't supposed to matter. But they flat locked them away over there, but they called them punk Nazis. I just kind of dug the term.
You punk Nazis.
Oh, son. Ran into a couple young ladies over to the dome last night. I promised I'd say hi to this morning.
Oh, you did, huh?
Yeah. This one, just a cute little old Mexican-looking thing. Her name was Sonia. And a friend of hers named Jerry, G-E-R-I, Jerry. Mm-hmm. Whew, couple little old black-headed, brown-eyed, good-looking, big puppy, voluptuous, darling little girls.
Now.
Darling little girls. And I promised them I'd say hi, so Sonia, Jerry, hi there. And meanwhile, back in Hitchcock, where we started this entire conversation, there was John. There were some of the prettiest little 15 and 16-year-old girls. I'm beginning to understand Tim Trostle.
Oh, now, come on.
Boy, these were high school girls, and they weren't that pretty when I was in high school.
You got to meet my old buddy down there, Brandon.
Annette Benavides.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, pretty little thing. Yes, she is. But do you remember the gal's name, that little blonde-headed thing?
Yes, I do.
What was it?
Terry.
Terry what?
Sanders.
Terry Sanders, was that it?
Uh-huh.
She was one of the prettiest women I've ever seen in my life. And I bet she must have been 14 or 15 years old.
No, I think she was older than that.
You think so?
I think she was a senior.
Ooh, I hope so.
Well, don't get any ideas.
Oh, come on now.
Hey,
what? What?
Senior, come on, high school.
Oh, okay.
You know, braces.
How old am I? 30, right?
Corsages. Okay.
Yeah, I'm 30 and I should not even think.
That's right.
They shouldn't send me to these high school appearances anymore.
They shouldn't.
I don't. Wow.
Hey,
I was a good boy.
Yes, you were.
I can lust in my mind.
If Jimmy Carter can do it,
I can do it. Ooh. Besides, it gave me something to think about on the way home.
Now watch it. Let's not verbalize.
And I did.
Yes, think.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Boy, she was beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Terry Sanders, right?
Mm-hmm.
Dates one of the old ex-jocks. And you know, I was telling high school, the guy that dates, or the lady that dates the captain of the football team. And she was that pretty. She was pretty enough for the captain of the football team. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. It's 6:18 in the morning. Again, it's going to be a beautiful day, man. I bet you the Cosmic Muffin gives us an 8 or a 9 today.
Close.
7, anyhow. Yesterday was a 7, and it started out like about a 3, but it ended up about a 9, so it pretty much averaged out.
So they wound up a good day yesterday.
Huh? It did wind up a good day, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Started out like hell just because we knew Ben was going to be in.
Yeah.
What? John's dropping stuff over there. Are you setting the control room on fire?
I think so.
If you're going to smoke those things, keep them in your hands.
Oh, heck no.
Oh, lordy, lordy. Got a quick joke for you.
Uh-oh.
What did one leg say to the other?
What did one leg say to the other?
Uh-huh.
What?
Said, look at old Shorty. He's growing a beard.
Moby, that's terrible.
I know.
That's terrible.
Good morning, 97 Rock. Good morning. Talk to me. I hear you breathing. Oh, man, why do they do? They said, listen to it ring and then don't talk. Hello, 97 Rock. Good morning.
Yes, can I say happy birthday to Shorty?
Look, is he growing a beard? Yeah.
No,
all right.
No.
Yeah, you bet. Happy birthday, Shorty. How many?
Huh?
How many?
26.
Wow. Old Shorty's doing good.
Oh, yeah.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Was that coincidental or what?
I hope so.
I want to say happy birthday to old Shorty. He's 6 today. Be 5 this time next year. Okay, you want to take one more or should we chance it?
Oh, let's chance it.
All right, here we go. 97 Rock, good morning.
Hi, can you tell me a joke?
Sure. Just like that, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. What's invisible and smells like honey?
I don't know.
Winnie the Poot.
Oh, crud.
See you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Winnie the
Mathews information injection comes up in a minute.
Baseball and football have their official rule books, and now so does the sport of...
What?
Watermelon seed spitting.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. The recent world championships in Dallas were governed by a new set of regulations. Now, blowpipes are prohibited, but you get an extra turn if you accidentally swallow your seed. However...
Do you have to use the same seed?
No. However, denture wearers who spit their false teeth farther than the seed still have to turn to the judges for a ruling.
For a decision on
that.
Yes,
right. All right, judges.
You know, it'd be kind of funny just kind of swallow a seed and eat some beans on top of it and say, watch this. I can kill the dog with this sucker.
Oh, no.
Pow!
And with 97 Rock Sports, here's Hannah Starr.
Oh, good morning, John. How you doing, Moby?
Moi?
Yeah.
It's your fault I didn't get much sleep last night. John had that awful, that poor girl.
He's talking about the game.
Oh, yeah. You wish, Mama, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How'd you like that game?
I had good seats, Hannah, and thanks. Yeah. Hannah took care of me.
Yeah, how'd you like the game?
The game was fine. We got a bad call when Joe Niekro went sliding into second base. The pitcher gets a hit, and then they do a bad call on him. Oh, it's awful.
Yeah, we had one of those TV screens, and that guy was way up in the air.
Yeah, so was the ref,
yeah,
or the ump, or whatever.
That was a bad call. Well, some good things happened. Montreal did score 3 times in the 8th inning. They did dash the Astros' hopes of winning their first season opener since 1980. Yeah, pretty bad. Pete Rose, it was good to see him out there.
Do those,
he collected, huh?
I want you to do those stats about the scores were in the opening games over the past 3 years.
Well, in the past 3 years, we've been outscored 32-10. Yeah.
That's enough to lose a whole bunch of games.
Yeah, not real encouraging there. But hey, I thought the Astros looked real good. Of course,
I did too.
We did get beat 4-2, but they appeared to be very confident. They played aggressively.
Played like a team.
Yeah, they sure did. And I think, they're not off to the best start that they could, but hey, last year they went 0-9, and I don't think they want to do that again.
And they won't. They're going to win tonight. Nolan's pitching tonight.
That's right. He sure is.
So it'll be good.
It'll be real good.
Can you get me some more free tickets?
Well, I'll try. He's just disappointed there's not any cheerleaders out there.
That's all right.
Well, former Cougar Clyde the Glide Drexler now thinks that Olajuwon's statement that he'll return to the University of Houston next year is just talk. Drexler says that the 7-foot junior may declare hardship status for the June NBA draft. Clyde claims that Akeem just made the statement that he was going to come back to get reporters off of his back. And the Cougs' Alvin Franklin and Michael Young were among the 74 players invited to the 1984 Olympic trials. Trials are under the direction of Olympic coach Bobby Knight. They run from April 17th to 22nd. Yeah. And eventually that squad will be narrowed down to only 15 or 16 players.
I just got this feeling I'm not going to make it. Read your commercial, Hannah.
Sports this morning has been brought to you by Casino, a Las Vegas-style nightclub in the Galleria area in the posh Las Vegas tradition, located at 3333 Sage at Richmond. For more information, call this number, 777-7777. More sports in an hour.
777-777.
You got it. I'm Hannah Storm for 97 Rock.
She's Hannah Storm for 97 Rock.
Thank you, Hannah.
They got pretty girls over there at the casino, too.
I'm sure they do.
And pretty guys.
Well,
so you can go, John.
Thank you very much. Appreciate
no problem.
That. 97 Rock Traffic brought to you by
Kuppenheimer. They've started their 2-for-sale, 20,000 suits, 2 for $99 and 2 for $369 and everything in between. Kuppenheimer's with 6 great locations all around Houston, John.
Listen, at Plainfield, the lights are flashing South Loop eastbound between Long and Broad. There is construction in the left 2 lanes from 8 until 3 this afternoon. Southwest Freeway outbound between West Park and Beechnut, there is construction in the left lane from 6:30 until 3 this afternoon.
And the Washburn Tunnel will be closed until tomorrow morning. Use Highway 225 or I-10 to either East Loop or to the East Belt, its alternate route.
Yeah.
Sunny and warm today and tomorrow. Clear and cool tonight. High today and tomorrow in the mid to upper 70s. Low tonight in the mid 40s. Northwest winds increasing to 15 to 25 miles an hour by late morning. Right now in Houston, it's 53. And on the Bay, it's 57. I'm John Mathews, 97 Rock.
Thank you, darling.
You're
so
welcome.
So they're fixing to burn them one over in Florida, huh?
And Louisiana.
And Louisiana. Mm-hmm. Electrocution on both?
Yes. Electric chair on both of them.
Wow. Well, you know, in Florida, they're cutting corners now.
How so?
Well, they don't turn the juice on anymore.
They don't?
No, uh-uh.
What do they do?
Well, they strap the guy into that chair.
Yeah.
You know, in the electrocution room.
Mm-hmm.
They put new wool carpet in there, and they have all the guards scoot their feet around and all touch him at once.
Oh, no.
You didn't know that, did
no,
you?
No, I didn't. No.
Saves on power. Good morning, everybody. It's 6:29. Get your lazy asses up.
97.
Yeah.
Timeless rock.
Houston, get your lazy asses out of bed.
How can I just let you walk away? Just let you leave without a trace? When I stand here taking every breath with you. Ooh, you're the only one. Really knew me at all.
Get your lazy asses up, Houston, Texas.
Philly Collins on 97 Rock. Gets all odds. Soundtrack from the movie. It's 6:36 in the morning time on 97 Rock. Y'all get your lazy asses up. Let's go. It is beautiful outside, man. I'm very anxious to see what the cosmic's going to give today.
Oh. What do you think it's going to be if you had to take a wild guess?
Oh, it's going to be a 7 or better.
Think so?
Yeah, I feel that. That's at least my internal says that.
Hey, you know, okay.
Hey, wow. No, I feel good today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I know why.
Why?
A couple of my favorite people are in town.
Who's that?
Chuck DeBear and Don Belushi.
Belucas.
Whatever. From New York City.
Mm-hmm.
I'm lying. Not my favorite people. It's just, you know, we got a brown nose them. They're in town.
Yeah.
Trumper's boss and Trumper's boss's boss are in town.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, I'm good buddy with Trumper's boss's boss's boss. You know what I mean? They only come in to make sure I'm doing all right and that we don't need anything here for the morning program.
Is that right?
Yeah. They come just to scope things out.
Well, that's good. Glad they're here for that.
The vice president of ABC Radio and the president of ABC Radio mm-hmm. are in town. Over to Tides 2, I think. I'm not real sure. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. You know, maybe they're not at the time.
Maybe not. Maybe
Happy
not.
Birthday to Herman Lutcher, L-U-C-H-E-R, 30 years old today. Hurts, don't it, Herm? Oh, buddy, bless your heart, man.
Be a great day for you.
Yeah, Brenda Casper is 24 years old today, too. Sue Marriott is 17 years old today. And I promised Kamikaze Dave that I'd say hi to him and hi to all his buddies over at the Art Institute. Kamikaze Dave is the one that had the artwork done with stickers across the back of his window. I don't know if you remember me talking to you about it or not, but it was on like an old Renault.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not sure. Well, it doesn't matter what kind of car it was. Anyhow, across the rear window, it had the the I love stickers. Mm-hmm. You know, I heart this stuff. It had Moby, I love 97 Rock, crank it up.
Oh,
all the stickers across the back of his window. Yeah. Took up the whole back window. Looked pretty slick.
Good.
Yeah, looked pretty slick. Took up about the same amount of room as the sticker for the high school for performing in, and what is it?
High school for the...
Performing in visual arts or something like that.
Something like the HSPVS for performing in visual arts, I believe it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Long bumper sticker.
Yeah, right. Anyhow, it takes about the same amount of room as Moby Allen 979. Crank it up. So mm-hmm. there you can visualize it yourself. Hokey dokey. Good morning, everybody. Get your lazy asses up. Get your lazy asses out to the bed. Oh, mate. Got a new song for you, John.
You do?
Yeah, it's funky. Well, oh, Lord. Yeah. Gotta get black here with me. Yow. Yow, yow, yow. Well, I wrote, you ready? Here we go. Ruthie rode my motorbike. She rode right in back of me. I hit a bump at 75 and rode on ruthlessly. Yeah. See, Ruth fell off.
Yeah, right.
And hit the bump.
Ruthlessly.
Ruthlessly. Did you like that? You want to hear it again?
No.
Ruthie rode my motorbike. She rode right in back of me. I hit a bump at 75 and rode on ruthlessly. Once again, rode on ruthlessly. Shoot.
Somewhere Muddy Waters is cringing.
That wasn't that bad for a white guy. Come on. If the ocean were whiskey and I was a duck, could you handle this? I'd dive to the bottom and never come up ruthlessly. Ruthlessly.
All right, Houston, get your lazy asses out of bed.